Everyone, this is Santana, software trainer. Today we are going to learn what is web development. Web development is nothing but developing an application or a product. So what is the difference between web application and a product? Is web application, it is a service based application. It's nothing but an internet based application, or it's a window based application. But product based applications means which we see with our visible eyes, like mobile phones, computer hardware devices, or whatever products we are delivering or we are giving, which we can feel with our hands, that is called the product. To develop the application, whether it is a window based application or a web based application, we need some basic task which we need to start with. That's the path we are going to follow now, or let's start with the basics. So first, before creating an application, what are the things we need? We need to interact with the client. We need to start talking with the client, whether it is a face-to-face talk or whether we can have an email conversation. We need to get the requirement from the clients. Once we got the requirement from the client, so what is mean by requirement? Requirement is nothing but getting the information from the client. What are the things they need as an output of the development? We need to get it from the client. So once we get the requirement, we are going to start the process with the creation of a template. So what does mean by template? Template is like a replica of our website. We are going to show it to the client to make the client satisfied. For the creation of the template, we are going to use some 2D softwares like Photoshop, CorelDRAW. Once the client finalizes the template, we are going to start designing the application. So we are going to convert the template to the next level, which is called web designing. So in the web designing, we are going to design an application. What is mean by web designing? Web designing is whatever we see as a template, we are going to make it somewhat to partial functionalities or added to the application. What are the things we need for web designing? We are going to use a language called HTML, which is for designing the basic layout. In the earlier stages, HTML is the only language they use for designing the web applications, but HTML has its own disadvantages. We can't make alignments, we can't add margins, we can't position the images. So they created a new language called CSS, which is cascading style sheet, which has some styling functionality. So with HTML and with CSS, we are going to design the web application, and the person who are working in this process are called web designers. So they'll be using HTML and CSS to do the designing process. Once the designing is done, they move on to the next stage, which is called JavaScript. In the JavaScript phase, we are going to give validation to the forms and some other features which we need to validate in the website. For example, in Gmail or in Yahoo or any of the website, whenever when we try to enter some login, we used to get some error messages if we enter an incorrect username or password. That error messages are done by validation. That validation will be done using the language called JavaScript. So using JavaScript, we are going to validate our designed application. Once the validation is done, we are going to move on to the next stage, which is called the programming stage. With this stage only, we are moving on to the development. We have many programming languages for development, and one of the programming languages Java, and the another one is .NET, and the third one could be PHP. So these all are programming languages. Whatever is preferred by the client, we can use it, or whatever the language we are using in our company, we will develop the applications based on that language. So in that three languages, Java and .NET or licensed applications, we are going to get the license for commercial purpose. PHP is the open source programming language which is free to download. Anyone can use it. It is a non-licensed language. So these are the three programming languages which is widely used for web development. The next stage is what is called database server. Database server is nothing but storing your data in the backend. So whatever the information entered by the user should be stored in the database server. So we have multiple database servers available, and the database servers are Oracle, SQL Server, MySQL, and we have MS Access. In that, MS Access, Oracle and SQL Server or licensed servers, and the only open source server is MySQL. So again, what is the link between the programming language and the database server? Whatever the language we are going to use, for example, if you are using Java, the recommended database server is Oracle. And if I'm using .NET as my programming language, the recommended server is SQL Server. And the only option for PHP programming language is MySQL, because both are open source. That is, PHP and MySQL is an open source software. We have a clear idea about the whole web development process. Thank you.